anyways, we're gonna see. We're gonna see the Dash on Dorinthia. So Dash coming in here round two, definitely both these players 1-0. So they both won their last match. So we're gonna see the roll here. Anything? I mean, you're definitely a mech player yourself. Anything you want to see on the mech and Dorinthia matchup?
Well, as a mech, I would love to see as many defense reactions as you can throw at the warrior. Just stop them in their tracks, get your board up. I mean, this is like as heavy control as you can get there right now. And as a Dorinthia player, well, I mean, do Dorinthia things, I suppose. Just try to get in as many attack reactions and as many big hits as you can. I don't know if you have any more insight on what the warrior player should be doing here.
Sure. So, I mean, it really depends on... We don't have access to the deck lists for Swiss anyways, but I would assume to think he's going wide warrior. It's possible that he goes tall, but assuming he's on the wider side, which is a little bit more standard at the moment, I would say he just really needs to keep tempo. He needs to be aggressive. He can't let Will set up with his items, obviously. I'd be very surprised if I saw any less than like 6 unmovables coming out of Will and a bunch of sinks and fades, right? So really it's all about tempo and timing here. So as the warrior player, I would definitely want to go as wide as possible.
And also judging by the armor piece we see here, he is using the Courage of Bladehold and not a tunic.
He is using the Courage of Bladehold.
Yeah,
I am curious to see whether that's kind of a regular side for him. Maybe he practiced it a little bit the night before. It might be. I don't know if he used the last matchup. I'm not sure if this specific to mech, but we're going to see how this turns out for him. So we have Dash. We have Will going first. We'll see what he can do. Just kind of starting off with a pitch, loading up his items. He's probably going to swing in here.
Yep. So we have an attack for two here being blocked, gaining go again with the chamber, spending the last resource to charge the chamber and pitching for, I believe, three more. There we go.
Yes.
Charging the gun and choosing not to attack, keeping it charged up.
Yeah, it's turn one, so I'm not really super surprised. I mean, Matt's just going to block with another thing and just draw two cards instead of one card, right?
Yeah.
So not really super surprised. We're going to see what Matt can kind of bring as a turn two to see what kind of tempo he can bring. He's just pitching a hit and run, swinging with Dawnblade.
Okay, so likely a few attack reactions here. If I were on the other side, I would probably assume.
Yeah, for sure. Just like kind of naked kind of.
Yeah, exactly. Here, so. Maybe Will's a twinning blade.
Yeah, Will's just blocking for three here.
Okay.
Matt gonna give him the good old glint. Good old glint Quicksilver.
Okay, gaining go again on the weapon and drawing a card here.
Yes. Oh, he's gonna... He's gonna add Overpower Blue for four, so it's gonna be two plus two for the reprise. He's got a Fate Foreseen from Arsenal, though.
That's the perfect block that he needed to prevent the sword from gaining the extra attack. And
oh, yeah.
There's one more attack reaction.
So we have a
three more.
Yes, we do have a Red Stroke of Foresight. Interesting card, reprise effect. So he's going to be able to essentially opt one more or less. That's more or less what he does. He gets
with
to draw
no cards
one.
In hand, exactly.
Yeah, draw he gets one. To draw one, put it on top or bottom. So he's going to draw into a card, put it on the bottom, it looks like. He's going to put it on the bottom, and he's going to come in for three damage. Yes.
Now, I believe he has no resources left here. So even if he does hit with the Dawnblade, he cannot attack again with it.
That is correct.
Luckily for Will, yeah.
Yeah, he just kind of wants to push the three damage. Doesn't really want to arsenal the card. I mean, fair enough. It's only turn one, right? You don't want to...
Yeah.
Important cards in the matchup, at least in my view. Things like Iron Song Determination... things like especially if he's running a lot of attack reactions, things like route overpower, things that really get over those defense reactions like big unmovables and things like that. Definitely key cards to watch to see whether Matt decides to put in the arsenal setup for a big play or kind of chip away at Will's armor and see if he can land one of those kind of bigger hits to swing momentum.
So here we see another pitch for three, spending two to charge both the pistol and the chamber, attacking once. Oh, that's right. Yes. So he couldn't. He attacked twice, I guess, with the
mm-hmm. Yeah, he attacked twice. Loaded up the induction chamber and just kind of passed along. Will does want to kind of load up as many items as he can. So he's probably just waiting on a bit of a critical mass here to then start poking Matt out here. We did see an energy potion on Matt's side. So which is interesting. You know, energy potion, great card, mm-hmm. warrior to negate those kind of unlucky all red hands, just in case they do come up. The energy That's potion right. still allows you to do some stuff here.
Yeah, interesting take, actually. Yeah.
So we do have Will just kind of poking in, go again, play the purifier, dash, doing dash things, right, trying to run fast.
Just got to get as many of those items as you can early on, and whenever you do draw it, just play it.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, there's really no like that is the game plan here for dash. So I would be very surprised to see something out of the ordinary on that regard.
Sure. So here we see a pitch for three and attacking with Dawnblade out the gate.
Interesting pitch, time snap potion. That is definitely a tech card if I've ever seen one. Not sure. Like that can't be standard. I'm not Matt Rogers, don't get me wrong, but I haven't seen time snap potion kind of standardized in the warrior deck so far.
Time snap versus Twinning Blade. I wonder what the I guess you get the go again. Yeah, I guess it's a bit of a different scenario there. Yeah, you get to go again. You have to hit first time with the weapon to be able to attack again. So yeah, interesting tech choice for sure. Yeah.
Yeah. We do see the second red fate for scene coming out, blocking an Iron Song response with the glint, which is blocking the full amount of damage here because he's blocking for seven on six right now.
That's correct. Yep.
Ooh, we got the route.
Okay. So route adding on, I believe, three damage.
Yeah, route adding on three, so sending back the zipper hit to the back. Yeah.
Okay, so nine damage on four here. Sword does have go again, so he will be able to swing one more time, although I believe he's out of resources yet again. Oh, no, he has cards in hand. I'm sorry.
Yeah, he does have two cards in hand, so he will be good to if he wants to pitch something, to use Bridge Forge Bracer, swing in again. He's going to be swinging in for four. Important to note here, Will does have a full hand. Depending on what that hand might be, he might not care, right? He might have some items, he might have some D-reacts or something like that. Yeah. He might be able to very easily block the second swing regardless.
We are seeing, so the first one does go through here for five damage.
Yes, yes. So first one, so bringing him down to, bring Will down to 32.
Okay, we have a pitch for two here and attacking once more.
Opting not to... Unless he verbally said it. Yeah, he might have verbally said it and just not put the counter on. I'm not entirely sure. He is blocking for six here.
Mm-hmm. Overpower red. Wow.
Right. So he did have the one floating. So he did crack the energy potion, go up to three, and use the red overpower for
six
plus,
more, I believe.
Yeah, plus six. Yeah.
So hitting for nine once more, taking three damage and gaining the counter on Dawnblade. Very nice.
That is extremely... extremely well played by Matt, of course, kind of knowing what his options are. Will opting not to play anything else, still has two cards in hand. We'll see what they are.
Yeah, looking to be a purifier charge. Yep. Mm-hmm. For one, popping it for plus one damage on the pistol, and for three.
Yep, so just get a pitch for three, load it up, use it. So pistol shots are now coming in for three this turn. Matt's got a full hand, nothing in arsenal, but he does have that Dawnblade counter. That is kind of a good tempo breakpoint for him to kind of look to push a little bit more damage. Every attack's coming in for four now.
Spoils here. So,
So spoils
is a pretty
three.
Good card. So, a
very good
kind
card.
Kind of wondering what else he's got up his sleeve here.
Yeah, it's a good card. Luckily, this is CC, so he does probably have three of them in the deck. So, probably okay, like kind of ditching the first one.
And he does take the second hit for three there.
Yeah, going down to 35. Yeah, probably wants to keep tempo. So three card hand is whatever he has is kind of what he believes. I would expect to probably see him just swing in. He might have an attack reaction and he might want to put the other card in arsenal, or he might have a bigger attack reaction. So he needs to pitch and play
pitch,
the other one.
Right.
Yeah. So those are the two kind of scenarios I'm kind of, if I was the dash, that's what I would be looking at.
I think it's safe to assume here he's playing a gold tall warrior.
This is definitely not wide, but he does have flock, so you know he's
fair.
He doesn't want to give it up completely.
With oh my goodness!
red overpower. You saw the route earlier. Those are not.
Yeah.
He could have easily built one of these Dorinthia decks that just has the side into mech, right? So it kind of it goes wide standard, but you have a tall sideboard kind of thing, right?
Yeah, I think that's necessary too to get over the unmovables, as you mentioned earlier. So how much are we seeing here? 7 damage on the left and 4 defense?
We're seeing exactly.
Oh, sorry,
other
way around. Yeah,
7 attack, 4 defense. Exactly. We're seeing 4 defense, so we're seeing 3 go through. Matt's going to keep his Dawnblade counter, and he's going to Arsenal the last card, so kind of scenario number 1 that I mentioned before.
Yes.
He did have an attack reaction, and the other card is going to be put in the Arsenal.
The response is such a good card. Iron's not response. Okay, so we're seeing pitch for 3. Spending 2, charging the chamber and pistol. Same start as last turn here, and we are attacking for 3.
Coming in for 3, looks like Matt's going to take the first 3 here. Going to pop the induction, pitch a question mark.
Yellow. We got a glimpse of it. Okay.
Yeah, there we go. Yellow immovable here.
There we go. Charging everything back up and attacking once more for his final action of the turn.
Yes. Final action of the turn. Important to note for Achilles Accelerator, he does need to boost to use it. In case he does want to kind of go even wider, he will have to boost something to kind of use that to be able to gain that extra action point.
Yep, exactly. So we see a block with the courage for 2.
Mm-hmm. Okay, taking block for 1. 2, take 1. Yep.
And that equip does have the tamper keyword, or temper, rather.
Yes.
So it will be broken the next time he uses it to block.
Or not, or maybe he blocked with it. It's possible he blocked with it earlier and we just missed it and there was a counter on it. It is possible. TTS does do that sometimes, where
okay. Items well, kind of... So he didn't pop it, right? He pitched 3 here now, and he's attacking with all of his resources, I believe.
Yeah, he...
1-1-1, yeah. Okay.
That is actually interesting. I'm not sure if he just popped it, or he just... Because that could be either, right? That could be...
Yeah, he could have popped it with 1 resource floating here, or he... Or we just missed an attack or a block.
Well, it's possible he'll just say 1 floating, like audibly. Oh, yeah. No,
oh, there
he
you
popped
go.
It. There it is.
He
yeah,
popped
okay.
It. Makes
that,
sense.
Thank
okay.
you. Thank you, Matt, for letting us know what's happening here.
Let us in on it.
So he is
how
popping.
How much damage
it.
Are we seeing here? We're seeing 3
spoils,
from spoils.
Spoils is 2, Supremacy is 2, and Dawnblade is 4. So we have 8 total coming in.
8 attack. There we go.
Yes. 8 attack, go again. Draw a card on hit. Very, very strong. 2 cards in hand, 1 floating.
All he's missing is Dominate. That's
all he's missing is... if he put an Iron Song Determination, that is 8. That is the turn right there. Will does have... Yeah, Will has 4 cards in hand, 1 card in Arsenal. Could be an unmovable in Arsenal. Could have a movable in hand.
He did pitch
yellow, yes.
My guess would be a red unmovable here for 9, or an 8 block, I'm sorry.
Yes.
From Arsenal, so...
I might even overblock if that were me, just to be like,
yeah,
let's...
just to prevent the Dawnblade from getting the ability to attack twice that turn.
Just in case he has like a attack reaction to get over it or something like that. Mm-hmm. Unless I also have like a 0 cost dereact.
Yeah.
So there's the Twinning Blade.
Okay,
very good card. So he's going to be able to kind of skip the Dorinthia must hit to attack again. He's going to be able to attack again regardless because the spoils go again.
So he did overblock, as you kind of suggested.
Yeah.
Anticipating another attack reaction here, but he did have Twinning Blade, so he is able to swing again.
Hit and run. I love that card. Coming in red. So he's going to, hit and run costs 0. He's going to use his last floating to activate Bridgeport Bracers. So hit and run is going to give him plus 3 on his sword swing. He's going to have the plus 2 from Steel Blade.
Supremacy, plus 1 from the bracers here.
Yes, so we're going to have 1 plus 3 plus 2 plus 4. That is wizard math on Warrior 101.
Yeah, so it looks like a buff of 6 plus the attack of 4, looking at 10 damage, I believe.
Yeah, that is very... I mean, Matt knows his stuff, don't get me wrong, but he counted out that energy perfectly to be able to kind of swing for that critical mass.
Mm-hmm. And that's where you can really see the courage of Bladehold shine to be able to this kind of turn.
Getting
a discount of 2, basically.
Yeah, exactly. That tempo swing, like Dash is at 26. If he hits here, he's gonna be able to keep his counter. Very, very strong turn. I don't think Will with two cards can block 10 here unless he uses equipment. Let's see if he decides to kind of use Skullcap, Teclo, and something. Even
Yeah,
then.
so that's technically a possible block. Four on the Skullcap Teclo, and then two cards for six.
Sure. If he had like let's say he has like another oh, never
Maybe
mind.
taking the full 10.
Yeah, I mean
What is
he doesn't want to break the armor. He's probably waiting for Iron Song Determination before he uses armor for the block, is what I am imagining he's thinking about here.
there? And he did cash in those two copper tokens.
He
I
I if
wonder if he'll be using them.
I would not be surprised if I saw a cash in coming into Matt's hand here. Honestly, I've seen weirder things happen.
We've already seen kind of the meta being a bit different in this, or rather the deck build being a bit different from the meta here. So who knows what kind of wizardry lies in this deck.
For sure. Sorry, the card that Matt drew was because of the second hit for Steelblade Supremacy, so he did draw a card off that. So I think he's just
So it's in
so
his
so
hand.
what
Okay,
yeah so what so what happened here is he got the second counter because he was able to swing in again because Dorinthea wasn't triggered on the first hit. So he used Twinning to attack one more time. Then he used Dorinthea on the activated on the second hit, and he had another swing for it. So he actually came in for another four.
And the hit and run did give go again on the weapon, right?
And
So he
exactly,
was
the hit
able
and
to
run
hit
gives
three
go
times.
again.
Wow.
Exactly. And four plus two because of the Steel Blade Supremacy. So he went down from 16 to 10 and drew
Makes
another
sense.
card.
And drew a second card. Yikes. That's probably the biggest warrior turn I've seen to date, being honest.
Yeah, who needs Tunic when you can do that, you know?
Yeah.
I mean,
I think a courage well spent, honestly.
oh, I absolutely agree. Will really only has the purifier to show for it here. Honestly, unless Matt bricks like four or five times in a row here, it's going to be a bit of a uphill battle for Will to come back to this. Pitches
So
on
he
a movable to
pops.
swing.
Yes. He did pop Purifier, I think, to gain the extra damage there and blocked for
Sure.
one on the bolters. He took two damage. Okay, and back to the warrior. And he did create two more copper tokens from attacking
He did.
a
He
second time
did.
there, so.
Waiting for the cash in, patiently
Yeah, I
waiting.
mean, I'm really hoping we see one. Matt just taking his time here, thinking about his play.
Yeah, he's just like, do I want to win the game now? Do I want to wait a
Yeah.
little bit? What do I want to do here?
I want to put on a show or just finish it off right now?
Give the viewers what they came here for, you know?
Definitely. So we are seeing a pitch for three here and an attack with the Dawnblade, two floating
Sure.
resources, and it's coming in for five because he has two
Yes.
counters on it.
Coming in for five. Not something I expected to say in a Warrior versus Dash matchup.
Yeah.
But it is coming in for five. Three cards in hand, two cards floating, one card in arsenal. Will is probably, if I were Will, I need to block this attack, like with everything I got.
Use two unmovables, block for 15, just do what you gotta do.
You
Okay.
know,
So he is opting for one only.
yeah, he's using the one from the arsenal, I believe. This is one from the arsenal. Yeah, so this is a
Yes.
red
So
unmovable coming in for eight.
block. That's correct.
Okay, let's see what Matt's. He's got Matt's got to have something here. I would be very surprised if he had nothing else but a swing for five. Interesting to see that this is, I believe, the second time Snap Potion we've seen.
He did pitch the first one. That is
So
correct.
he's gotten more than one time snap. Interesting. I was confused about the first one.
Yeah.
Apparently there must be a lot of playtesting here that I'm not seeing because I'd like to. Yeah, I guess it must
I
have.
guess
Oh,
you
we
don't
have.
have to, rely on cards like spoils, I guess, to get the go again.
No, that's fair.
Yeah, I
So we
wonder.
see, is that a red overpower? It looks like
That
a red
is for
overpower.
six more. The reprise effect.
So
Well,
the
he can remove it
unmovable
from
will
our spell.
resolve. Yeah, so unmovable
Right.
resolves and he can respond with overpower with reprise. But he does have the sink below, so he is blocking for 12 here against Matt's 11.
Correct. Yes, six
So
plus five.
he will get the counters successfully.
Yeah, that's a big win.
And yeah, it is quite a big win. I mean, cost him most of his cards, but like honestly, you can't let him have two counters. It's just you're not gonna have fun. So Will's just gonna Arsenal and pass.
I wonder if he's running a full playset of those overpowers, because this is
not the second. Third. Yeah.
Well, is I guess the... yeah, second red, second blue we're seeing. So.
Yeah, so we did see a red earlier, and then a red just now, and then we've seen a blue pitch and a blue pitch. So he might be running the full suite with the time snaps and trying to, go big.
Yeah, this looks like as big as he can get, really. So we are seeing, out for blood. Buffing by three more. So I believe he's seeing six damage against a seven block right now.
Mm-hmm. Got the red sink below from hand. Yep. We'll see if Matt's got another attack reaction he wants to add.
Pitching another overpower, just as we were talking about it. So
okay,
another six. So what do we have on the right
unmovable.
Side?
Unmovable. Okay.
12 damage. So that is a full block.
That is barely, I think, a full block here.
A 14 block, I believe. 7 plus 7.
Yeah, 14 block. Yep.
Against a 12 here. Wow.
Mm-hmm. That is one way. Yeah, that is, you know, you I see right now on my screen I see four different overpowers and I see a lot of unmovables.
Yeah, I mean that's I guess the classic offense versus defense that you kind of
I mean, yeah, Matt is definitely going tall, there's no doubt about that. The flocks are kind of cool, but he kind of wants to get a lot of kind of ways to gain go again really cheaply and easily. Time snaps are a good way to do it. Flocks, good way to do it. So that's probably his plan, is just to go tall once or twice and maybe swing for the fences with courage, which he did manage to pull off.
Right.
And this might be a very specific tech
for a mech matchup.
For the mech matchup to be able to go on top of the immovable, because red overpowers come in for six.
For right? six. That so... almost nullifies the immovable.
Exactly.
Yeah.
We just.
It's harder for Warrior to muster up the resources to play overpowers, but
he's
doing okay.
It looks like he is running a fair amount of blues, as we do see like time snaps. Yeah. I don't know if we saw an energy potion earlier.
We saw one at the beginning. Yeah, I believe he used it on the turn that he played his courage.
Mm-hmm. So he is running. He is running some extra blues to make sure he's been able to pay for those red overpowers, and we saw route. There could be three routes. There could be two routes. I'm not even.
Okay, he blocked with a Warrior's Valor red.
Mm-hmm.
Pitching a blue
Iron Song response here.
For a blue Warrior's Valor, I believe.
Yes, I believe it is a blue Warrior's Valor. That's going to come in for plus one. If the Dawnblade hits, it'll gain go again.
Gains go again, right. Starting with a flock. Okay. Interesting.
Oh, he's... he's showing the 20 blade. As the cost for flock, so he's going to show that.
Okay. So attacking with Feather, he does create the Quicken token here.
Mm-hmm. So it's going to come in for five.
Mm-hmm.
Quicken very strong in Warrior decks. Gaining the free go again on attack actions, on... Dawnblade swings, extremely powerful, especially with cards like Twinning Blade that allows you to even go again, right? So even when you have a go again, if you have another source of go again,
ability.
Like Refraction Bolters or something like that, right? Because Matt still has Refraction Bolters up, so he can pretty easily kind of negate the second piece there with Twinning Blade if he gets overblocked, or he could use it to just swing for a third time, right? So very, very strong kind of card in combination with a Quicken token to do all that for free.
Definitely. Okay. So classic mech turn, pitching for three, charging everything up, attacking once, using pitching two more to recharge the used chamber there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we do see
the first hit, I believe.
Yeah, he did take the first hit for three. He was a 26. He's probably gonna take he's taking the second hit.
Yeah. He knows that he's got the upper hand right now.
Oh, so he's got a Quicken token.
Tempo is the name of the game right now for
he's got the Quicken and five cards. Well, four plus Arsenal. He's feeling pretty good. He's got supremacy. Yeah, he's got the Quicken.
There we go. So we're coming in now for five and a automatic go again with the Quicken token here.
Exactly.
And on he's got hit, the card.
Yeah.
For the entire turn.
Yeah, he's gonna look to go probably a little bit wider, given that I didn't see I didn't see any kind of tools indicating that he wants to go really tall, like more like Dauntless and stuff like that at the beginning to like really make the swing really large, like sharpened steel Dauntless kind of thing. We're just gonna see a block for two for Skullcap and four for Fate Foreseen, so six total, I believe.
Correct. Yeah, he didn't use the skull cap yet. That's right. So six block, Twinning Blade, giving the weapon the ability to attack twice in one turn.
Yeah, it just gets a Dorinthea because he didn't actually land
The
the
free
swings.
Dorinthea. Yeah.
Yeah, so he didn't land the swings. He's gonna use Twinning Blade to do it regardless. He's then gonna play a red hit and run to give his next weapon attack.
Plus
Well,
three.
it's weapon or attack action. In this case, it's gonna be probably the Dawn Blade. So he's gonna give it plus three and go again. Steel Blade's still in play. He's gonna swing again with the Dawn Blade coming in for 3 plus 2 plus 3.
Right, eight, yeah.
Yes. Eight with one card in hand, no floating.
No floating.
Really seeing the power of Twinning Blade in this matchup. I think it's a great. I personally, my own warrior deck goes really wide, so I play Twinning Blade regardless. But even in this kind of matchup, against unmovables, Twinning Blade is really your friend. Fate Foreseen, all these D-React heavy decks, Twinning Blade really allows you to just go around it, use Hit and Run, and just come in for another buffed attack, especially
Yeah.
with cards like Supremacy, Ironsong
That
Determination.
last multiple attacks, right? Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, that lasts the whole turn. It really allows you to like go wide and go hard, like go a little bit taller with a couple buffs here. So
It
I
also lets you
really
pace
like.
yourself too a little bit. If you attack small, they use an unmovable and expecting like a big attack, you can always just kind of say, okay, I'll hold off this attack and then I'll buff the next one.
Exactly. You have so many options. I
Yeah,
really do
there's a
like the
lot of
card.
flexibility with the card. It was a great addition in Crucible of War,
I
100%.
agree. Among others, I mean, of course, Hit and Run was also a very good
Warrior got a
addition.
lot of nice stuff.
Warrior got a lot of nice stuff. That is true.
We are seeing a full eight block, Technofoundry Heart plus six from hand.
Yeah, and Matt's probably like, this is great. So when I pop in this Ironsong Determination, you're not gonna have that much. You're gonna have two armor to block with, right? One from the heart, one from the skull cap. So if I'm Matt,
Definitely.
I'm liking that. I'm liking that a lot.
Definitely. And Arsenal one card, passing it back. QCA pitch. Okay, I have a chamber. Not something I'd expect to see here, but
Yeah.
do what you gotta do, charging the pistol, ending turn there.
Yeah, I think I don't think Will th I think Will doesn't think he has enough time for setup at this point. He just needs to survive.
Oh, spoils coming out from Arsenal. Pitch for three. One resource floating, and that will be coming in for five, I believe.
Yeah, five go again. Will's got Arsenal and then a full suite of cards here to work with.
We see a block for
I'm guessing six.
six. Yep, looking like
Yeah.
six to me. Passing back priority. Okay.
Stroke of Foresight with his remaining one floating. So
That
it's
is
gonna
a
be plus
red
three. Yeah, that is a
three.
red.
So we're looking at eight attack versus six defense right now.
Yes, he's going to use the reprise here. So he's gonna draw one card and he's gonna decide to put a card on top or bottom. Note this can be any card. It doesn't have to be the card he drew, I believe.
You are right, yes. That'd be basically opt.
Yep. So we do see a response. So it is going to block the full three with a four of its
Yes.
own.
Correct. So a full block. Oh, okay. And a time snap potion being played.
I
The
think,
go again came from spoil, so he was allowed to
yes.
play that.
I think I'm kind of understanding more and more when I see Matt's deck the whole point with all these potions, because with so many ways to go again and so many
Yes.
twinning blades, you either swing again with the weapon. Or you play a potion and pass. It's really a win-win, right?
Yeah, maybe time snaps are played so that you can play other time snaps afterwards.
Exactly.
That could definitely be a possibility. So here we see an attack for three. He did use the purifier. Pitching more. Three more, I believe. Spent one on the
Yes.
pistol once again. And he will be attacking twice. I believe they're both fully blocked for three
Yes,
each,
he
so.
blocked with a stroke and a Warrior's Valor.
Correct, yes. So, okay. Pitching one, attacking with Dawnblade for three.
Pitching the Razor, one card in hand, one card in Arsenal. So really what I'm looking to see here is I'm willing to bet that Matt is waiting on, like, obviously the nut's hand. If the hand comes, the hand comes, right?
Yeah.
If they got a good hand. Or he's waiting for Iron Song Determination, right?
Yeah, I think that's the ideal. With no Arsenal 2 on the mech side, you're pretty much guaranteed to get a really good turn off if you draw the Determination there.
Exactly. So we see now, Will's got no Arsenal card.
Matt seems to be hovering a card over his remove from play area.
Not sure. TTS could have bugged or something.
Might have been an overdraw here.
That is possible. I mean, TTS is known for having these kind of buggy things. I've seen people draw, but they draw their whole deck instead. I've seen
Looks
that one happen a lot.
Just to kind of be a bit of just to make sure that full transparency, this is what I drew, putting it back on top.
Yeah, this was the last, because Will can see that is the last card he draws, because it is an order of top to bottom of your deck, so he is able to see that. And so Will just kind of pitching and swinging again, as you'd expect, two cards in hand, pitching one of them to do so.
Gain and go again. Spending the last two resources. Pitching three more for the pistol here. And attacking again for three.
Yep, so Matt did take the first one for three, so it's down to 17. Interesting to note, I mean, at one point, Matt was at 30-something, 31, I think, and Will was at, like, 10. Yeah,
Will's doing pretty well, all things considering.
So I think Matt is just, like, with all these potions, you're not going to draw gas every single turn, I think, is the key here. So he can have these really, really big turns to swing tempo, but it is also possible if you brick a little bit and draw maybe too many potions, because I think I saw him pitch one, and then he played the time snap, so he had two potions in his hand kind of thing.
Yeah, and it's great that he can kind of capitalize on those kind of less strong turns by building up for new turns afterwards.
Exactly.
I think that's probably the goal of a lot of these cards. See.
Yeah, he is now swinging just for three. Three cards in hand, one card in arsenal. Pitching the glint, so he has two resources floating. Will's just kind of checking his options. Will does not have an arsenal card. Just the four cards in hand, which Matt must be happy about. He's probably not expecting too many kind of reactionary reacts in the arsenal kind of thing, which Will would definitely be prepping.
Your unmovables aren't in arsenal. It kind of makes you feel like you're not using them to their full potential. So it could hurt a little bit to use them from hand, knowing that you could have gotten more out of them. But we are seeing a pretty big block for seven here.
Block
so expecting,
for seven.
Expecting one attack reaction probably. And there we go. Like we talked about. So instead of buffing this attack, he's able to play the twinning. And although he did not gain a go again, I believe.
He didn't. He just wants to get it out of his arsenal.
Yeah.
Oh, no, he did. He used Time Snap Potion.
Oh, okay. I missed that. Okay, that explains it. Okay.
Yeah. I'm just like, well, oh, yeah. He played Time Snap at the beginning, so he gained two actions.
Perfect. So he was able to navigate around this.
Exactly.
Attack again. Yeah. Great play.
Yeah. So he twinninged, and now he's going to Warrior's Valor. So if he hits, he's going to swing again off Dorinthia. That's the power of Twinning Blade.
That is an insane turn.
Yeah, Matt.
It's amazing
Matt,
to see like how he's navigating these cards.
Yeah, definitely. First time we've seen him play Dorinthia since Crucible, I want to say. He probably hasn't played Dorinthia in a while.
We do see a full block for six, but adding on three more damage with an Iron Song response, going up to nine here.
Exactly, so he's going to get three through.
Impossible to block now. He only has one defense on the deck low, so he is going to take the three.
Red out for blood. Going to swing again for three damage.
For only three, I believe, yes.
Yeah, get a counter.
Doesn't have enough for the Brave Forge Bracers, unfortunately.
Yeah, he might be... I mean, Will might be thinking about blocking with tech low, but...
Yeah, I
mean,
he's
taking three
it's
here.
A bit rough to use your counter when you're not actually blocking an attack. You're still taking the damage, so... Might as well save it for when you do have only that one block remaining to block a Dawnblade attack. So,
for sure. So then we just see Matt drawing up, and then Will has no cards. So he's drawing up, so it's back to Matt's turn.
Pitch for three here. Supremacy being played. Dawnblade attacking. So we're going for six, I believe.
Six. We've got one floating. Yeah. We've got one floating. We've got two cards in hand with Matt. I think he's considering going for game here. So if I were, yeah, he's looking at the armor. He's looking at seven.
We'll block for, oh, okay, for seven. Okay. I wonder why he threw the Teclo in there.
I am
What
not.
creature should be
Well, oh no,
blocking?
he needs to full block because Dawnblade is. Oh, I actually don't
It's
know.
only, yeah, so he's
The
only kind
extra
of
one.
overblocking by one and kind of using the item there or the
He
equip
might.
there.
I mean, he might be worried about a blue attack reaction because
Could possibly.
all of the blue one. Yeah, all the blue attack reactions.
That one, yeah.
Yeah,
No, that's a
exactly.
fair point. Oh, and Singing
Singing
Steelblade, does
Steelblade.
that add one?
Yeah, so it does add plus one. The reprise effect lets him search.
Perfect. So that was a great idea then.
Yeah.
Not knowing that he didn't see a single one being played yet, kind of assumed that maybe he had one in hand.
It's true. Either that, yeah, exactly. Either that or all blue attack reactions that cost zero or one from Warrior do only buff by one blue Out for Blood, blue Iron Song response. They're also only coming for plus one, so he might be thinking like he
Yeah.
might be running blue attack reactions to pitch for other things, but he could still
Use them
use.
effectively.
Exactly. Like you're
Yeah.
using it for game, that's still a good use of
Oh,
a blue attack reaction,
100%.
right?
Yeah, totally. Okay. And actually,
We
one
could be
thing too is
searching.
that we have not seen a determination yet.
We
So
have not.
I wonder if he even runs them.
That is a good question. I'm curious. Ooh,
Another,
another.
okay. Okay. So, I mean,
Oh, he's looking for overpower, isn't he? Oh no, he's looking for the
jeez.
third Singing Steelblade.
So how many resources has he spent? I think he only has one left, and so he just spent it on an Out for Blood here. So
Yeah,
I think
he
he's
spent it for
out.
Out for Blood.
And that is coming
That's
for
six.
six, eight. Is that 12 damage? So he has to
Six, eight, 12. Yeah,
only
12
have
damage.
five more defense. He needs four defense to survive the
I
game.
mean, yeah, if he either has a D-React in his hand,
Or
Will needs to do something
that's
here.
right. So for one Sync Blow would be enough, or one Fate for Scene would be enough to go down to one HP, I believe.
That is correct. Interesting that he singing into singing into singing. It's
Yeah.
out. There must be, I mean, we obviously don't know a deck list, right? So there could be a very good reason for that.
Else could he have done? Just kind of gone for overpower from the beginning. Although I don't think he has any left.
If he did, yeah, that's the key. I think he wanted to, and then we remembered that he used all the red ones
Yeah, that's
earlier.
right. Yeah. Because he only added on, I think, five damage, one Out for Blood, two Singing Steel Blades. Overpower would have been six. Oh, and there we go. No block,
Yeah.
so that's the
So
winner.